What is going on, everyone? My name is Naughty, and today I've got myself another 9 packs of Team Coach coming off of yesterday's 10 packs of Team Coach. We're going to have ourselves another 9. What a week for Team Coach. Look at that. But we've got ourselves a lot of mail here today. A lot different to yesterday where we had more packs and just the one mail where we got that gallery wildcard of Nat 5. Today, we've got 3 different packages, all ranging in the amount of stuff that we got. So today, I'm going to be showing you guys all of it. Starting off with this one, which I've already got pre-opened because it does have some information on there that I'm not going to just give away like that. But let's see what we got. First off, we've got a fair bit here. This one's very, very exciting. This is a 3-card trade that I did. We have ourselves a Todd Marshall Magic Wildcard, which I also have with me right next to it, the Gold Wildcard version. I pulled this one and I've traded for this one, which is really, really nice. We've got ourselves the Lukey Parker Gallery Wildcard and the Scott Pendlebury Gallery Wildcard as well. Now, this trade I made with 3 cards that I didn't have as duplicates, and you may be asking why I did so. I ended up doing this because this card is so, so difficult to get for a reasonable price. It is a Collingwood card. It's Scott Pendlebury, who is a well-known Collingwood player. And same kind of deal with Dacos, in that Scott Pendlebury is going for ridiculous prices on eBay. It's very hard to scoop him up on Facebook pages for a good price because everyone's kind of looking out for him. Same with Nick Dacos. He's just a very, very tough person to pull and receive online. It's just very difficult to get your hands on him. So I made the trade with someone who was looking to send this one off for cards that they didn't have. So I handed him a card that I had that I thought was reasonable for me to send off. And in doing so, I made a little bit of a profit going trading 3 for 3 in this Scott Pendlebury. I managed to pick up a card that I traded for less than $20, which is usually what I aim for. If I can pick a card up for less than $20, then I'm more than happy to take it out of my collection and then buy it online again. So that technically, I buy this for less than $20, which is really, really good. But nonetheless, 3 nice little wild cards that I can now add back to the collection. Let's go to the next one, because I'm interested to see what this one was. I can't remember off the top of my head, but we keep it going. Hey, there we go. This one's really exciting. This one is the player that I'm going to be chucking in to my Team Star Powers team next week for round 11 if he hasn't gone down with an injury, because I have seen injury news about Clayton Oliver that has got me a little scared. Cannot lie, it has got me a little scared. But Clayton Oliver, nice little Team Star Powers card that I can finally add to the team. So, very, very good to have him along. Last package, which has got a fair bit in it from what it feels like, or it's just got a lot of protection. We'll find out. Here we go. It's in a select pouch. Sticky taped up. Lovely, lovely. We love to see it protected. Open this bad boy up, and we've got a fair few cards in here, which is great to see. We've got ourselves a lot to work with. I believe I purchased all of these. Jack Sinclair, Magic Wild Card for a nice price. Hugh McCluggage, Magic Wild Card for a nice price. Bailey Fritch, nice little wild card there. And Dane Zorko, beautiful stuff, managing to pick up 4 new wild cards to the collection. You love to see it, don't you? You love adding new things. This star wild card was one that I ended up trading off. This Dane Zorko, no longer in my collection, I believe, as a part of this trade. But now I purchase it back off someone else for a better price. And again, what ends up happening is I end up purchasing one of these cards for less than $20. Again, really ideal for myself. It's all just a lot of thinking. You got to think it all out when it comes to trading and purchasing online. You got to realize which ones are going for the most, where you can find the best bargains and where you can find the best cards, and just being there at the right time sometimes. It really, like, it can come down to that, just being there at the right time, because some cards are really, really hard to pick up purely because everyone's looking out for them. So, Jack Sinclair, Hugh McCluggage, Bailey Fritch, Dane Zorko, Todd Marshall, Luke Parker, Scott Pendlebury, and a Team Star Powers of Clayton Oliver. What a start to the video. I'd like to think that's a pretty good start. So, without further ado, let's get into our 9 packs of Team Coach. 9 more packs today, guys. This is going to be a really, really exciting video. These packs are guaranteed to have some big hits. I am saying it right here, right now, with 100% confidence, because the last 3 weeks have shown me that these packs They have to have something in them. They have to have, I'm pretty sure, at least two big things in them. We'll be seeing a bit of gold. We'll be seeing some really nice colouring in our star powers. We may even see something case hit related. That is not guaranteed, but there is potential. There is a chance, and I'm hoping that we can manage to hit on that chance here today with nine packs of Team Coach 2023. You guys know the drill already. Every single Wednesday we do these packs, but hopefully you guys are enjoying it. I will ask right now, if you do find the content that you are watching enjoyable, be sure to like the video and subscribe to the channel. We do this every single Wednesday, so I'm hopeful that you guys can join along with us. But nonetheless, Team Coach 2023, nine more packs. Let's get straight into it. How quickly will we start seeing our big hits is the big question here today. I'm super keen to see just exactly as well how long it'll take, as this one has been quite poorly cut. You can see at the bottom here. That's not good. It's not good. We've got Ben Mackay to start though. From Mackay, we have Bradley Hill. And from Bradley Hill, what do we see in the start? It is a normal star powers of Connor Rosie. Okay. Starting off a bit quiet, not getting too crazy just yet. We gotta wait, we gotta be patient, because if we're not, then we don't deserve the big hits. We don't deserve the case ones. However, I will be honest, I wanna see a case. I wanna see, well, the one big hit that I've seen so far, and that I've pulled so far. Actually, I've pulled two case hits technically. One of them was a double case hit. First cards were actually upside down. So are they upside down here? No, they're not. They're normal up. That's the only thing that I know. However, when I got a gold wild card, the pack orientation was normal. There was no change. Cozzy Pickett, though, to start this one off. Oscar McInerney. Gold Ben Hobbs. Little Ben Hobbs action right there. Would have loved a gold Ben Hobbs rookie wild card. Is that still on the table? Let's hope so. I can only hope, but man, I'm just interested. Like, there's nothing that, if you haven't before, the feeling when you do pull like an absolutely crazy hit, it's, I guess, undescribable. Like, I feel like the chest sink feeling, that feeling of joy and excitement as to what exactly you've got, that feeling of luckiness as well. I don't know, like, when I pull something big, I get this feeling of like, wow, I'm really lucky. But I'm hoping that today we can manage to relive that moment. Jeremy Cameron to start this one off. Josh Dacos, what are we seeing here? It's a team, and it's Noah Anderson. Oh my god, this is my third. So, team star powers. This is my third Gold Coast team star powers, and it's another new one. I'm collecting all of the Gold Coast team star powers cards, man. I can't find any others. This is actually hilarious. I have Jared Witts. I have Ben King, and now I have Noah Anderson. I've pulled all three. I haven't bought any or anything. I've literally pulled all three, and my luck with Gold Coast cards is apparently just unmatched. I apologize to any Gold Coast fan out there who may be watching and go, how does he keep doing it? I don't know. I don't have the answers, but that is kind of ridiculous. Noah Anderson, Gold Coast team star powers. All right, we'll take it. It's a box hit. I said there'd be some big ones, and there it is. I'm pretty sure we've got one more at least to come. With the odds, I'm pretty sure we have to have at least one more, but I do not expect us to get a fourth hit today, unfortunately. We do have Luke Shuey, though, in here. Jamara Ugglehagen. And the normal star powers of Sam DeKooning. We do have Sam DeKooning already, so nothing too crazy right there. Yeah, my luck for Gold Coast is apparently out of this world. I'd love it to be North Melbourne or like something properly good, like an actual good thing to like properly be happy about. But I guess we just got to live with what we've got. We've got Jai Newcombe here though to start this one off. Newcombe goes to Rory Sloane Scanlins. I haven't seen too many Scanlins in a while. But from Scanlins, we have an odd bods. It's going to be 2 meter Peter. Okay, I like this one. I do really like this one. 2 meter Peter is a very, very funny looking odd bods. I will give it that. This is probably my favorite odd bods, 2 meter Peter. Because people actually call him that. There's no like ridiculous nickname to it. It's one that's been given to him, and like it makes sense. It makes sense. It's quite funny. But we go to the next one. Okay, I'll give it a team coach. This pack opening hasn't been too bad to start. We've got ourselves, this is our fourth last pack here. Let's see what else we can do. I want to see something massive though. I want to see something massive. Isaac coming. Jack Rewald. What do we see from this one? We see ourselves a normal star powers of Charlie Cameron. sharp shooters. Again, I'm almost certain we do have to have a double box hit in here, because the odds would recommend or would suggest that every single box has two double box hits. So I'm gonna rule out case hit. I'm gonna rule it out because I don't think that's possible at this rate. But I'm almost certain we should be seeing a double box hit somewhere within at least these last three packs. I feel like that has to happen, right? Surely. Next up though, Jack Ginnivan. So it's Caleb Daniel. And what are we seeing here? We're seeing another normal star powers. It's Will Day. I do have Will Day. Nothing too crazy about this silver star powers, but I'm getting nervous, man. I'm really hopeful that we haven't been scammed or anything like that, or I've just gotten my odds wrong, because I feel like it has to happen, right? So, like, yeah, best and fairest gold are one in every two boxes. And where's the other one? Fantasy duos are one in every two boxes. And considering that there's 12 packs, it means there has to be six of each in every case, meaning that there's always one in every box, right? It feels like that has to be the case. There's no chance that we don't get something here. I feel like that has to be the case, at least. We got ourselves Lockie Neal, Peter Wright, and what are we finding here? Another normal star powers, it's Nick Nat. We do have Nick Nat. This is our last pack. Are we really leaving it to the last pack? Are we really about to do that? Or am I just completely wrong? Am I completely wrong and we only have the two hits? This is gonna be very interesting, man. I'm hopeful that this last one has something in here, man. Because otherwise I'm gonna feel very let down. I'm gonna feel very, very let down. Come on. Prayers. Mark Blitzov to start this one. Callum Mills, and then what are we seeing? It is a normal star powers of Cody Waitman. That's really weird. I feel like that's not even possible. I feel like something has to be wrong here because, like, I definitely thought you had to have at least one every box, either fantasy duo or gold best and fairest. Because obviously there's one in every two boxes, but there's two of those ones. So it'd be alternating. Every second box is a fantasy duo and then a gold best and fairest, then a fantasy duo, then a gold best and fairest in every single box. But no, I'm very wrong apparently. Apparently I'm wrong enough that I completely fooled myself. But nonetheless, I guess that's it. Okay, I'm not mad at all, as we did manage to get ourselves a nice little box here in Noah Anderson. A third, as I mentioned, Gold Coast team star powers. But I won't lie, I'm a bit shocked. I thought we were gonna get at least two. I didn't think it was even possible, fair enough. But nonetheless, that is it for today. If you guys enjoyed the video, be sure to leave a like, subscribe to the channel if you are new. We're gonna start a fresh new box next week and hopefully see some better results as well. But nonetheless, thank you all so, so much for watching this video, and I'll see you all in the next one. Goodbye.